ACT MP Karen Chhour was drawn to politics by her own experience growing up as a Māori child in state care. But even though more than two-thirds of children in contact with Oranga Tamariki are Māori, Chhour says ethnicity should not be a consideration in deciding what's in a child's best interest. She wants a law change that she says would help to make Oranga Tamariki, quote, colourblind. This follows a case in Napier in which Oranga Tamariki have been attempting to remove a Māori child from adoptive Pākehā parents, which is being challenged by the courts. Karen Chhour is with us now. Tēnā koe, Karen. Thank you for being with us this morning. The section you want changed, the law you want repealed, is Section 7A. It was introduced in 2019. This policy reinforces that if children and young people are unable to go home, Oranga Tamariki must strive to achieve permanent care that meets the needs from within their family, whānau, hapū, iwi or family group. Why do you want the section removed?
Oh, hi, Jack. Thank you for that introduction. Can I just make a quick correction to one of the statements that you made at the very beginning, saying that I didn't want whānau or hapū to be a consideration in where children should go? That's not what I'm saying. Culture and history is very important, and where we come from is very important. What I have an issue with is when it overrides what's in the best interests for our children. So, yes, family, iwi or hapū are a great place to start, but that's not always possible. And I just don't want it to get to the stage where we are overriding the best interests of our children.
Okay, we're joined now by Lady Tureiti Moxon, who is a child advocate and is involved with a group of dames who have been challenging the state over the state of Oranga Tamariki. Tēnā koe, welcome to Q&A and thank you for being with us. Why should 7A, Section 7A, remain in the Act?
Well, it's the one thing in the Act that actually protects our children, protects our whānau, hapū and iwi, and protects who we are as Māori. Unfortunately, what's been said at this time and place is incorrect. Because even the Waitangi Tribunal, in both the health and the Oranga Tamariki claims, have said even that clause is reductionist. So it becomes so watered down, no one pays any attention to it, and that's certainly been the case where these children have been taken away, actually stolen from their families before they're born and after they're born. And that's... It's just got to stop, Jack.
So Lady Moxon, to be clear, you're saying that Section 7A, or 7AA, introduced in 2019, isn't working?
Well, what I'm saying is that it's better than nothing. And so far, nothing has been really improved in terms of what has been done in terms of Section 78, for example, where they're just taking our children still willy-nilly and never giving them back. It's one thing to remove a child from a family and for that child's safety at that moment in time, but they never give them back. And what we've been saying forever and a day is give them back, support the whānau to be the best whānau they can be so they can look after their own children. And that's the issue that we have here when you think that these children are actually being uplifted and taken into state custody and hawked around all over the place so they're given to the four winds and they never know who they are. And I tell you what, the trauma it causes those children, the pain and suffering it causes those families is irreparable. And yet, we still think the state is a better parent. And we know for a fact, after 14 failed reports, 14 right. failed audits, and after the Ombudsman's report, the Waitangi Tribunal report, the Whānau Order report, and the Children's Commissioner's report, this is not the case.
All right, Lady Moxon, I'm just going to hold it there. I want to make sure we stay focused on Section 7AA, which is the section that Karen Chhour wants removed from the Act that governs Oranga Tamariki at the moment. Karen, I know that your journey through politics and you're a first-term MP at the moment has been driven by personal experience. Could you talk to us a little bit about your background here?
Yeah, so I mean, I was raised in the beginning of my life by my grandparents, and like Lady Moxon says, it's fantastic if you can have family members that can love and care for you, and that should be an option. But to say that there's no other protections within the Oranga Tamariki Act is not quite right. Within sections 4 and 5 of the Act, a lot of these issues are taken into account. My issue with section 7A is we get this perception of a separate system for Māori and non-Māori. And I agree, the system is very broken. There are major issues with Oranga Tamariki, and Oranga Tamariki can cause a whole lot of damage and re-traumatise our kids all over again. Mm. And I'm not arguing against that. But if I thought that section 7A was for all children, and not trying to separate us and divide us into different categories, then yes, 100% I'd be behind the idea of family first, whānau first. But when I get non-Māori people contacting me saying they have brought this up as an issue with OT and said, what about Section 7A within the Act? They are told that that's only for Māori, and you're not Māori, so that doesn't apply to you. So whether that's true or not, I don't know if that's legally true, but that is the idea that has come through Oranga Tamariki, and that is the attitude that's coming through. And as far as I'm concerned, all children that go into care should be treated equally, and all our children should have the same rights and the same opportunities to have a better life and to become their best selves.
Okay, I just want to be clear on something. I know from your personal story, when you were in state care as a Māori child, that social workers said at the time you couldn't be placed with your grandma because she was too old. Even though your grandma had previously had custody of you, even though she wanted to take you, even though you wanted to be with your grandma, if 7AA had been in place, would you have been able to stay with your grandma?
From the stories I'm hearing now, no. Nothing's really much changed.
But sorry. I mean, to be clear, though, you know, 7AA specifically says that Oranga Tamariki effectively must strive to achieve permanent care that meets the needs from within a child's family, whānau, hapū, iwi, or family group. So the way I interpret 7AA, you, as a child in state care, would have been placed with your family, with your whānau, with your iwi, with your grandma.
Not necessarily. And that's the problem. It's become too, like Lady Moxon has said, it's become too watered down. It depends on interpretation, and it depends on which caregiver you get and which social worker you get. And this shouldn't be happening. We need an absolute definition of what the intention is, and make sure if we do have a legislation or a piece of legislation in place, that it's been followed for all children, so that all our children have the same opportunities in life. And this just isn't happening. And whether or not that section was meant to be separate or not, that is the impression that that section is giving, and that is the attitude that the department is giving to the public. Mm. Now, it was created with the best of intentions, and I really understand what the intention was, but unfortunately, that's not what's happening.
Mm. Lady Moxon, I'll come back to you on that. More than two-thirds of children in contact with Oranga Tamariki are Māori. Has a colourblind system, to use Karen's term, served children in state care in the past?
Well, it certainly hasn't served Māori, and it certainly hasn't served our children. At least Section 7AA, gives an opportunity for these parents to be heard, because they haven't been heard. They have just uplifted children under Section 78 and just taken them away. Section 7AA is there for Oranga Tamariki, and it does give them a steer, but they are not implementing it. And if we don't have that protection there, all we're going to be doing is taking more and more children away, causing more and more harm, causing more pain and suffering, and dealing with the kinds of issues we're dealing with now, where we've got children who belong nowhere and don't know who they are or where they belong. And that is the big issue that we've got in our country that we're facing. Mm. And so what we've got is we've got Oranga Tamariki, which is feasting on the backs of our people's misery. And that, Jack, has to stop.
To be clear, when Oranga Tamariki are placing a child in a home, do you think they should prioritise whakapapa over finding that child a safe, stable, loving home?
No, no. What they should be doing is speaking with the whānau, talking with the whānau, looking for the best possible solution for the whānau. And you know, for some reason, everybody thinks that Māori pet whānau can't be trusted and there's no safe and secure whānau anywhere. Mm. Well, that's not true. That's a fallacy. Mm. And, you know, the thing is, Māori can do this. Māori can do it for ourselves. We've been doing it for ourselves for thousands of years, and we will continue to do it as long as the state stops interfering with whānau. Mm. And the other thing, too, about the child, taking a child out of a whānau in the best interest of the child, who said that the best interest of the child was not to be with their whānau? Where did that come from? Who's been perpetuating this view that Māori are undeserving, Māori are bad parents, the state's a bad parent, let me repeat that, and that Māori can't do it for ourselves? And there's nobody in the whole world within our whānau, hapū and iwi who can take care of that child.
Right.
For too long, they have looked at other people to look after our children.
I think one thing we can all agree on is that it is a national disgrace that two-thirds of the children who are in contact with Oranga Tamariki are Māori. So, Karen, for the final word on this, I want to come to you. If we are to address the root cause of these issues, what do you think needs to change in New Zealand?
I think it's a societal attitude. We need to realise that all our children are vulnerable. They are born vulnerable. They rely on us to give them the love and the care that they deserve. And unfortunately, in some situations, this just isn't happening, and we can't deny that. We can't deny there are homes where these children just aren't safe. Not all Māori, not all non-Māori are perfect parents. We can't pretend that. Mm. And we have an obligation to protect these children, but we also have an obligation to make sure that when we do go to protect these children, we're putting them in a better environment than what they came from. Mm. And also wrap around the services of the family that this is happening to and try and get them to a place where they are capable of being the best parents that they can be. And I don't think our system works, and I do agree, but what I don't agree with is that the system is just broken for Māori. It's broken for all our children.
All right. We will end the conversation there. Thank you both so much for your time. That is ACT MP Karen Chhour and Lady Tureiti Moxon.